始今天的崇拜，欢迎大家参加今天的聚会。
Welcome to our chapel service.
今天是在2024年我们在 BSOP 的第一次聚会，感谢耶稣，请大家把最大的颂赞归我们天上的神。
Today is our first gathering at BSOP chapel in the new year. Please give our greatest praise to our God in heaven.
在聚会开始之前，请大家做好以下的预备。
Before the trouble starts, please make the following preparations.
请将手机调为静音或者关机。
Put your phone on silent mode or mute.
暂时忘记我们在世上忙碌的事情，包括我们的工作、学习，还有未完成的作业。
Please forget about the busy things we are doing in the world, whether it's work, study, or unfinished assignment.
请聚焦在耶稣的身上，预备一个谦卑的心来领受今天的话语。
Focus our mind on God and be humble to listen His first teaching.
让我们一起来祷告。
Let us pray together.
亲爱的天父
Heavenly Father,
我们献上感恩，因为你带领我们走过2023年，迎接2024年的新的旅程。
We are grateful because you have led us through 2023 and are ready to start a new journey in 2024.
当我们今天再次聚集的时候
As we are gathering again in the chapel,
求主赐给我们更多的智慧来明白你的心意，并且知道如何去跟随你。
We pray for more wisdom to understand your will and know how to follow your plan.
让我们的生命更加像你。
Let our lives be more like you.
如我们受训所说，顺服基督，为他受苦。
As our school motto says,Believe in Christ and suffer for Him.
让耶稣基督的十字架成为我们的荣耀。
Let the cross of Jesus Christ be our glory.
让我们一起来到耶稣基督的十字架前敬拜，敬主十字架。
Let us worship together before the cross of Jesus Christ with the song Kneel the Cross.
请起立。
Please stand up.
这首歌我们会分为四段，第一段跟第三段我们会唱中文，第二段跟第四段我们会唱英文。
There are four stanzas in this song. We will sing the first and the third stanza in Chinese and the second and the fourth stanza in English.
求主使我今世家应有宝贵泉源，以智活水免代价，有哥哥他留下十字架，十字架我欢聚天家，人夸主是慈下 In the cross a trembling soul Love and mercy for me There the bright and morning starRighteous soul 是我今世家，思念昔日情景，在主十字架荫庇下，日日奔走天城，十字架，十字架。
带领我们今天的敬拜，荣耀归于你。
Heavenly Father, thank you for accepting our worship. Glory to you.
我们一起来读今天的经文。
Let's read today's scripture portion together.
马可福音十五章二十一节，有一个古利奈人西门，就是亚历山大和鲁弗的父亲，从乡下来，经过那地方。他们就勉强他同去，好背着耶稣的十字架。
Mark 15:21 A certain man from Cyrene, Simon, the father of Alexander and Rufus, was passing by on his way in from the country, and they forced him to carry the cross.
今天的讲员是我们非常熟悉的魏约尔博士啊，大家请坐。
Please sit down.
Sorry.
Today's speaker is Dr. Joe Williams.
他是我们学校的新约神学老师，他的妻子魏丽佳教授这里的中文生的英语。
He teaches New Testament and theology subjects at BSOP. He is married to Mrs. Rebecca Williams, who teaches English for Chinese track.Students.
这是他们在 BSOP 的第六年。
This is their sixth year at BSOP.
魏约尔博士和魏丽佳教授有三个成年子女，一个女儿，还有两个儿子和两个非常可爱的孙子。
Joe and Rebecca have three adult children, a daughter and two sons, and two very cute grandsons.
让我们欢迎我们的讲员魏约尔博士，还有翻译康宾博士。
Let's welcome our speaker, Dr. Joe Williams, and our interpreter, Dr. Kambing.
Happy New Year!
新年快乐
Yeah, and let's start with prayer, and we will ask the Lord to bless this year together for us here at BSOP.
那我们来祷告了，开始也求神来继续在新的一年当中祝福 BSOP。
Gracious Heavenly Father, we give this year to you.
慈悲的天父上帝，我们将这新的一年交在你的手中。
And we pray that you would help us to see every act of blessing that you give to us this year.
恳求你开我们的眼睛，让我们看见你在我们身上诸多的祝福。
And we do ask your blessing upon us as a community here at BSOP.
特别是作为一个群体，我们的确要恳求你在这里的祝福。
And I also ask you, Lord, that you would help us to understand your word today.
我们也恳求你，主，今天帮助我们能够明白你的话语。
Give us eyes to see and hearts to respond.
给我们眼睛能够看见，给我们心能够明白。
We pray this in Jesus' name.
我们正祷告，奉主耶稣的名，阿门。
Today we are looking at one verse, Mark 15:21.
今天我们只看一节的经文，就是马可福音的第十五章的二十一节。
And we just read that verse, but here it is on the screen as well.
我们刚刚读过那一节经文，但是屏幕上大家也是能看到。
It's a verse about a particular man named Simon of Cyrene.
这里讲的是有关一个所谓古利奈人的西门。
And the message this morning is about that man.
所以我们今天早上其实就聚焦在这个人的身上。
I want to ask two questions.
我要问两个相关的问题。
What can we learn about him?
首先就是我们能够知道他有关于他的信息。
And what can we learn from him?
第二点就是我们可以从他学习到什么。
So what can we learn about him and from him?
我们可以从他知道什么，并且我们可以从他学习什么。
What do we know about Simon of Cyrene?
我们对古利奈人西门了解多少呢？
The answer is not much.
答案是并没有特别多。
But there are a few things that we know, and in fact, I want to point out five pieces of information about Simon of Cyrene.
但是我们的确了解一些有关于他的东西。实际上，今天早上我要跟大家指出五点我所收集到的信息。
Number one.
第一点。
Simon of Cyrene at some point in his life lived in Africa.
就是这个古利奈人西门在某一段时间当中是住在这个非洲。
He's identified as coming from the city of Cyrene.
他这里讲到他是从 Cyrene 的这个城市而来。
Cyrene is a city on the north coast of Africa.
它是北非的一个海岸的一个城市。
To the west of Egypt.
也就是埃及的西边。
Today it would be in the country of Libya.
也就是今天的利比亚。
So the first fact that we know about him is that at some point in his life he lived in Africa.
首先我们所了解到就是在某一段时间当中他曾经住在非洲。
A second detail we know is that he was a Jewish man.
第二点我们所知道是这是一个犹太人。
Simon is a Jewish name and identified him as Jewish.
因为西门是一个犹太人的名字，所以我们就是把他看作是犹太人。
Sometimes people might think that if he lived in Africa, he was ethnically African, but that's not true.
有的时候我们觉得他住在非洲，那他就应当是非洲人，但是这可能不一定是对的。
During the time of Jesus, there was a large Jewish population that lived in the city of Cyrene.
在耶稣的时代的话，在那个 Cyrene 的这个城市的话呢，实际上有很多的犹太人在那里居住。
At the time of Jesus, there were more Jews living outside the land of Israel than inside the land of Israel.
在耶稣的时代的话，在以色列以外的犹太人远远多过在以色列以内的犹太人。
These Jews were called Jews of the diaspora.
这些在外面居住的犹太人被称为散居的犹太人。
Now, if Simon was from Africa and lived there, what was he doing in Jerusalem on the day that Jesus died?
那如果西门是这个从非洲来的话，那他在耶稣死的那天，他在那里做什么呢？
There are two possibilities.
有两个可能。
One is that he lived in Africa, but then at some point moved to live in or around Jerusalem.
一个可能就是他虽然曾经住在非洲，但是在某一段时间他开始搬居到耶路撒冷，并且住在那里。
So he had lived in Africa, but decided to move and live instead by Jerusalem.
所以他曾经居住在非洲，但是决定这个搬回到耶路撒冷。
The other possibility is that Simon was simply in Jerusalem to visit for the feast of Passover.
另外一个可能性就是西门就是只是在那个时间当中，在这个节期当中拜访耶路撒冷。
So he was just a visitor.
所以他只是一个访客。
Now, if I had to guess, I would guess that he probably actually moved to Jerusalem.
如果要猜测的话，我觉得他应当有可能是搬居到这个耶路撒冷的人。
In Acts chapter 13 and verse 1, the book of Acts is listing the leaders of the church in Antioch.
在《使徒行传》第十三章的那里记载的在那边的几位的领袖。
You'll notice that one of the men that's listed as a leader in the church of Antioch was Lucius of Cyrene.
你可以注意到在那安提阿的教会当中其中一个所列举出来的领袖就是古利奈人路求。
At some point, Lucius had lived in Cyrene, but had moved to Antioch in order to help with the church there.
我们可以想象这个路求也是曾经一个在非洲人在某一段时间就开始搬居到安提阿来帮助那边的教会。
So he no longer lived in Africa, he lived in Cyrene. He no longer lived in Africa, he lived in Antioch.
所以他不再居住在Cyrene, 而是搬居到这个安提阿。
Perhaps it was similar for Simon. At one point he lived in Africa, but now he had moved to live near Jerusalem.
很有可能西门也是类似这种情况，曾经居住在非洲。现在 搬回到耶路撒冷。
There really is no reason to refer to someone as Simon of Cyrene if he's just a visitor.
如果这个西门仅仅是一个访客的话，那可能不太有必要在这里特别去描述他为这个古利奈人的这个西门。
Here is a third piece of information.
第三点我收集到的信息。
Simon of Cyrene probably became a Christian, a follower of Jesus.
就是古利奈人西门很有可能成为一个耶稣的跟随者。
If you remember from Mark 15:21, Mark says that Simon was the father of Alexander and Rufus.
在二十一节这里讲到说，这个西门是亚历山大跟鲁弗的父亲。
Mark leaves the impression that the first Christians that read his gospel knew Alexander and Rufus.
这个马可写这个福音书的时候，给他的读者一个感觉，就是这些人是很有可能是认识亚历山大跟鲁弗的。
Those first Christians probably thought, "Oh yes, I know Alexander and Rufus. They're Christians like me."
这些读者有可能会去思想，哎，对啊，这个亚历山大跟鲁弗，我们的确认识啊。
And if Alexander and Rufus were Christians, then it seems likely that Simon, their father, was a believer in Jesus as well.
那如果亚历山大跟鲁弗是一个基督徒的话，那很有可能他的父亲西门的话呢，那也是一个基督徒。
Another clue comes here from Romans chapter 16 and verse 13.
另外一个线索是来自于这个罗马书的16章的13节。
In the second century, there were early church leaders who mentioned that Mark wrote his gospel while he was living in Rome to the church in Rome.
早期的教会传统认为，这个马可，这个写这个马可福音的时候，有可能是在罗马，然后也是写给罗马的基督徒。
The apostle Paul also wrote a book to the church in Rome.
这个使徒保罗也写了一封书信给罗马的教会。
When he sent this letter, he also sent a greeting to Rufus.
但他写这封书信的时候的话呢，他也这个给鲁弗问安。
This verse says, "Greet Rufus, chosen in the Lord, also his mother, who had been a mother to me as well."
那经文说又问在主里蒙拣选的鲁弗和他母亲安，他的母亲就是我的母亲。
Now I don't think that Rufus's mother was literally the mother of Paul.
我不认为鲁弗的母亲是他这个肉身的这个母亲。
Instead, she had cared for Paul like a mother would care for him.
Say it again.
She cared for Paul like a mother would care for Paul. She functioned like a mother, even though she wasn't literally his mother.
所以就是他只是这个某种意义上的母亲。
Did that make sense? Yes. Was this Rufus the same Rufus that Mark mentioned in his gospel?
我们要去思想，就是罗马书的当中的这个鲁弗是不是 马可福音当中所提到这个乳妇呢？
That seems likely.
有这个可能性啊。
And would it help explain why Christians in Rome knew who Rufus was when Mark was writing to them?
所以这也给人感觉就是当这个马可写这个信息的时候，他们是明白的。
Here's point number four.
第四点我收集到的信息。
This one is more of a guess.
当然这个更多是一个猜测。
Simon of Cyrene may have been a freed slave or the son of a freed slave.
那就是古列人西门很有可能是一个被释放的一个奴隶，或者是他是一个被释放的奴隶的儿子。
This information is based on Acts chapter 6 and verse 9.
这个信息的话是基于使徒行传第六章第九节的信息。
Before this verse, it's talking about Stephen, that first martyr of the church, and how he was witnessing for Jesus in the city of Jerusalem.
在这之前的话，讲到在使徒行传当中，第一个殉道者，斯提凡，他如何为主做见证。
Now I changed translations for this one point because the translations here make the point more clear.
我在这里特别选择了一些的圣经的译本，因为这些会把他的翻译解释得更为清楚。
Acts 6:9 says this, But some men from what was called the synagogue of the freedmen, including both Cyrenians and Alexandrians, and some from Cilicia and Asia, rose up and argued with Stephen.
就讲到说可能一些来自称为自由人会堂的人，包括一些古利奈人、亚历山大人，还有来自奇里奇省和亚利亚省的人。
Time of
在耶稣的时代。
During the time of Jesus, there were many synagogues in Jerusalem.
在耶路撒冷有很多的会堂。
And there was one synagogue that was especially for freed slaves.
但是有一个会堂是特别为这些的释放的这些得自由的奴隶而预备的。
The synagogue of the freedmen.
换句话说是为这些自由人而预备的。
And in this synagogue, there were many who were from the city of Cyrene.
但是在这个会堂当中有很多从这些古利奈的人而来。
Perhaps Simon of Cyrene was a part of this synagogue, and therefore may have been a freed slave or the son of a freed slave.
也许这古利奈人西门的话是在这个会堂当中的一个贩子，所以也许就这个推测的话呢，他也有可能是一个被释放的一个奴隶。
Here is point number five.
第五点我能收集到的信息。
Simon was forced to help Jesus.
那就是西门是被勉强去帮助耶稣的。
I think it's helpful to know that Simon did not choose to do this. He was, as this translation says, compelled.To help Jesus.
那就是注意在这里这个西门并没有选择去做，正如经文在这里所提醒我们，他是被勉强去做。
Other translations say forced.
有些的圣经译本讲到说强迫。
The whole punishment of crucifixion began with a beating or scourging.
就是整个的这个钉十字架的过程的开始的话是以这个鞭打这些来开始。
As part of the punishment, the Roman soldiers would beat the condemned man.
作为这个刑罚的一个部分的话，这个罗马人会鞭打这些的囚犯。
And they would beat him for as long as they wanted to.
就是一直鞭打到一直到他们想要的那个程度。
Within the Jewish court, there was a law that you could only beat a condemned man 40 times with 40 strokes. 40 strokes.
在这个犹太人的会堂当中的话呢，就是他们规定是鞭打四十下。
In the Jewish court, they would carefully count 39 strokes in the beating.
在他们当中，他们会仔细的去数算这个那个四十九下。
Always one short of 40, so that they would not break the law.
39 out of 40. 所以在这个 他们所鞭打的这个四十字之桌之中呢，他们总会少一次，也就是说 只会鞭打39次。
The Romans didn't follow any such law. They beat a prisoner as long as they wanted to beat him.
但是有罗马人才不管这些的规矩，他们就是想怎么打就怎么打。
The next step in the punishment is that the condemned man would have to carry his crossbeam to the place of execution.
另外一个刑罚就是这个罪犯的话呢，要背起这个木头去到那个被钉十字架的地方。
Usually it was just the crossbeam.
通常的话就是一个简单的这个木头。
The post or stake in the ground would already be at the place of execution.
那个主墓最后会被埋到那个土里面，然后它会被钉在上面。
Once they reach the place of execution, the crossbeam would be attached to the post, and then the criminal would be nailed to the cross.
所以一旦到达那个地点的话呢，那个罪犯就会被这个就会被钉在这个木头上面。
There, the man would be left simply to die.
然后那个人的话呢，就会在那里会死去。
Apparently for Jesus, he had been beaten so severely that he fell or stumbled under the weight of the cross as he was walking to the place of execution.
那显然在耶稣的这个情况的话，就是他被鞭打的太过严重了，以至于他没办法去这个再去承受这个木头的重量。
And therefore the Roman soldiers forced someone who just simply was passing by to carry the cross for Jesus.
所以罗马人就勉强这些随便的路人来去帮助帮忙去担这个十字架。
When Jesus fell under the weight of the cross, Simon did not volunteer to help.
当耶稣这个跌倒的时候，这个西门并没有这个主动来去要求去帮助。
He was forced to help.
他是被勉强去帮助的。
So here's what we know about Simon of Cyrene. First, at some point he lived in Africa.
所以这个是我们对西门的一个了解。首先，他在可能在某一段时间内居住在这个非洲。
Second, he was Jewish.
第二，他是犹太人。
Third, he probably became a Christian.
第三，他很有可能成为一个基督徒。
Fourth, he may have been a freed slave or a descendant of a freed slave.
第四，他有可能是一个被释放的自由人，或者是他们的孩子。
And then fifth, we know that he was forced to help Jesus with the cross.
第五点就是他是被迫去帮助耶稣的。
Now that's what we know about Simon, but what can we learn from him?
这个是我们对西门的一个了解，但是我们可以从西门学习到什么呢？
When I was working on this sermon, what I really wanted to know is, what did Simon learn from his encounter with Jesus?
当我在预备这边讲章的时候，我在思想就是，西门到底跟耶稣的这个会面当中到底学习到什么呢？
And what can we learn from him?
那我们又可以从他学习到些什么呢？
Is there a lesson for us?
有我们可以学习的功课吗？
As I was working on this, I thought,It would be so helpful if I could just send Simon of Cyrene an email and he could send an email back telling me what he learned.
当我在这样去思想的时候，我有一个很狂野的想法，就是我也许可以给西门这个写一封 email， 然后看看他会给我一些什么样的回复。
Surely by this time, people in heaven have access to email.
很显然西门是这个时候肯定是能够收到邮件的。
And so I sent an email to simonofcyrene@gmail.com.
所以我发给他邮件simonofcyrene@gmail.com.
And I tried simonofcyrene@hotmail.com.
或者是 simonofcyrene@hotmail.com.
And then for a joke, I thought I should send it to simonofcyrene@bsop.edu.ph.
后来我想一想，也许更有趣的，我可以发给他 simonofcyrene@bsop.edu.ph.
And then I was shocked that I got an email back from Simon of Cyrene at the BSOP email address.
然后我很震惊，最终我居然从他收到了。在 BSOP 的 email 当中居然收到他的回复。
I was so surprised, but he sent an email back.
我很惊奇，但是他的确给我回复了信息。
And he gave a wonderful answer about what he learned from his encounter with Jesus.
然后他给我了一个很奇妙的一个回复，有关于他跟耶稣的那一次的回复。
And it was such a wonderful email that I've decided to read it for you today.
然后这个 email 太过奇妙，所以我今天决定把这份 email 跟大家一起来分享。
So here is an email from Simon of Cyrene.
所以注意啊，这里是啊从 Simon Cyrene 给我的 email。
He says this.
他这样说。
Relax, it's a long email.
大家放松放淡定一些，因为这是一个很长的 email。
First, I wanted to mention that I asked a friend of mine here in heaven to translate my email into Chinese, since that might be helpful for you at BSOP.
首先我想提一下，就是我邀请了我在天堂的一位朋友帮我把这个邮件翻译成了中文，所以因为我想可能这对 BSOP 的这个群体会更有用。
You would be surprised how many Chinese are here. In fact, how many Asians as a whole are here in heaven.
你可能会惊讶，就是会有多少中国人，或者说有多少亚洲人在这里是在天堂。
Many have arrived in recent years, but many arrived much earlier in those first centuries of the church, as the message about Jesus spread across Asia.
很多人可能是最近这些年才来，但是也有这个很多是在教会最初的几个世纪就来，当然这个也是随着耶稣的福音在亚洲这个区域更多的被传讲出来。
In addition, I decided to write back to you in English since your email to me was in English.
当然，我决定在这里用英文来去回复你，因为你的 email 你是用英文来给我写 email 的。
I learned English a few years ago in order to communicate with the Americans here.
我在几年前也开始学会英文，因为为了要跟这里的美国人沟通。
As you know, Americans find it difficult to learn another language. And so many of us decided to learn English as a way to help our weaker brothers and sisters.
你也知道美国人这个学习另外一门语言是很困难，所以为了帮助这个他们，那我们很多人就决定也学习这个英文。
You asked about what I learned from my encounter with Jesus.
你问到这个我跟耶稣的这个会面当中学习到什么。
It was such a thought-provoking question for me that I wanted to answer your email.
这个当然是一个令人深思的一个问题，所以我决定回复你的邮件。
I learned that the most important thing I ever did for Jesus was a task that I did not choose.
我意识到的话，就是我为耶稣所做的重要的事情，并非是我自己主动选择去做的。
I will explain more about that later.
我等会会更多的解释。
You sent along the information that you were planning to share with me or share about me in chapel.
其实你发给我有关于在早会当中分享关于我的信息，大部分都是正确的。
Most of it is correct, except for the part about why I was in Jerusalem.
大部分是正确，但是除了我在耶路撒冷的这个部分的话，可能还不是那么准确。
Why was I there?
我为什么在那边呢？
That is a more complicated question, and it involves my family and the times that we moved.
这是一个复杂的问题，因为这个会涉及到我的家庭，还有包括我搬过去的时间。
My father was a Jewish slave in Cyrene, and he was trained by his master to serve as a business manager.
我父亲是古尼奈的一个犹太的奴隶，那主人也培养他来去管理他的生意。
When my father was set free, he continued to work for the same man, but now as a freedman or an employee.
当我父亲获得自由之后，仍然在继续为这个人工作，但是却是这个时候是以自由人跟雇员的身份。
That is why I grew up in Cyrene in a Jewish family.
所以这也是为什么我是在古尼奈的一个犹太人的家庭当中成长。
I met my wife Miriam at our synagogue there.
我也在那里遇见了我的妻子米莉安。
As you mentioned, we had two sons, Alexander and Rufus.
正如你所提到的，我有两个儿子，亚历山大跟鲁弗。
When those boys were still young, we decided to bring them to Jerusalem for Passover.
当他们还小的时候，我们决定把他们带到耶路撒冷要过这个逾越节。
I wanted them to see the temple and to understand their heritage and faith.
我想带他们过去看这个圣殿，让他们明白他们的这个他们的传统跟信仰。
It was during that visit that I met Jesus and became a follower of Jesus.
也正是在那一次的访问当中，我们遇见了耶稣，并且成为他的追随者。
My whole family believed in him as well.
我们的全家也都相信他。
So we decided to stay in Jerusalem and live there during that early and exciting time in the church in Jerusalem.
所以我们就决定留在耶路撒冷，在那边在这个教会激动人心的时候在那边生活。
That is how I became known as Simon of Cyrene.
所以这也是为什么我被称为这个古利奈人西门的原因。
There were so many men named Simon in the early church that every Simon needed an extra addition to their name.
要知道在教会初期的话有很多叫西门人，所以需要加上额外的一些的标志来去做区分。
That included Simon Peter and Simon the Zealot, disciples of Jesus.
比如说有西门彼得，还有奋力党的西门等等。
When the persecution started in Jerusalem, we stayed there even in the midst of all those difficulties.
当耶路撒冷的逼迫这个爆发的时候，我们在这个困难当中依然选择留在那里。
But eventually, we found it necessary to return to Cyrene.
但最终的话，我们决定还是有必要回到这个古利奈。
My son Alexander settled down in Cyrene.
我的儿子的话，亚历山大是在古利奈定居。
He married, raised a family, and served as an elder in the church.
他结婚有了家庭，并且在那边成为教会的长老。
My son Rufus took an interesting path in life.
我的儿子鲁弗的话选择了另外一条有趣的人生的道路。
After my death, he decided that there was nothing holding him in Cyrene.
在我去世之后，他觉得在古利奈没有什么值得他留恋的了。
He felt called by God to move to a place where the church was growing and where the church could use his help and leadership.
他感觉上帝呼召他去一个在教会正在快速成长，并且是需要他帮助跟带领的地方。
He first moved to Corinth, taking along his mother.
他开始带着他母亲搬到哥林多。
That is where they met the Apostle Paul.
在那里他们第一次遇见了这个使徒保罗。
Later, they moved to Rome to help the church there.
后来他们搬到了罗马去帮助那里的教会。
While he was in Rome, Rufus met and married his wife.
在罗马的时候，卢浮也遇见并且这个娶了他的妻子。
She was a godly Christian woman named Suda.
她是一个敬虔的基督徒的女子，她的名叫苏达。
They adopted three orphan children, a boy and two girls.
他们领养了三个孤儿，一个男孩，两个女孩。
They were named Solomon, Michelle, and Linda.
他们叫 Solomon, Michelle, and Linda.
As you can see, my family's movements were complicated.
你可以看一下我们家庭的动向是比较复杂。
And I do not blame you for finding it difficult to sort out all that exactly right.
所以你没有讲得很清楚，我也不怪你。
What did I learn from my encounter with Jesus?
我跟耶稣的相遇当中学习到什么呢？
I learned that the most important thing I ever did for Jesus was a task I did not choose.
我意识到就是我为耶稣所做的最重要的事情并不是我所选择的一个任务。
In fact, it was a task I would never have chosen.
实际上，这样的一个任务是我永远不会去做这样的选择的。
Let me take you back to that most important day in my life.
那我带领大家回到就是那个我生命当中最重要的一天。
You have no idea how crowded Jerusalem could be during Passover time.
你没办法想象就是耶路撒冷在逾越节期间会是有多么的拥挤。
We stayed outside the city in a tent.
我们在城外的一个帐篷里面居住。
Our pattern was to wake up early in order to crowd through the city gate in the morning and slowly make our way through the packed street of the city to the temple.
我们的习惯是早起，然后穿过城门，然后这个慢慢的穿过这些拥挤的城市的街道，然后去到圣殿。
Then we would spend the whole day at the temple complex.
然后我们会在圣殿的这个院子里面，度过一天的时间。
But that morning, the pushing and the shoving of the crowd suddenly became worse.
但是在那天早上的话，那个这个人群的拥挤变得突然之间变得更加的这个难以控制。
Roman soldiers were pushing the crowd to the side of the street.
这些罗马的士兵把人群这个推到这个街的另外一侧。
They were making room for a condemned prisoner who was carrying his crossbeam to the place of execution.
因为要让出一些空间给这个被犯罪的一个囚犯，抬上他的十字架去往这个行刑点。
With the pushing of the crowd, I realized that Alexander was no longer holding my hand.
在这些人群的拥挤当中，我发现这个亚历山大，居然，就是不再没有再握住我的手。
I looked around to find Alexander and to look for my wife who was holding on to Rufus.
我这个四处张望寻找这个亚历山大，也想找到牵着卢浮的这个妻子。
I could not see any of them.
但是我一个都看不见。
At that point, I felt two strong hands grab me by the shoulders.
但在那个时候，我感觉有两个有力的手的话抓住我的这个肩膀。
And throw me into the open space in the middle of the street.
然后把我扔到街道当中的这个空旷处。
The criminal had collapsed.
这个罪犯的话呢，已经跌倒在地。
He was face down in the dirt under the heavy weight of the crossbeam.
他的脸朝下，因为伴随着这个沉重的这个十字架压在他身上。
A soldier was beating him with a stick, screaming at him to stand up.
一个士兵正在用鞭子打他，然后对他喊着叫他起来。
The whole scene was so unfair.
整个的场面太过不公平。
The Roman soldiers treated everyone like their own personal slaves.
罗马士兵对待每个人都好像他们自己的奴隶。
They were demanding that I carry the crossbeam for this man.
他们要求我要替这个人背起十字架。
Why didn't the soldiers help with the cross? It's their job.
为什么这些士兵不抬起十字架呢？因为这个是他们的工作。
Where were the man's family or friends?
这个人他的家人或是朋友在哪里呢？
In fact, where were my wife and sons?
我的妻子跟孩子又在哪呢？
I strained around to look for them in the midst of the crowd.
我在这些的拥挤的人群当中四处去寻找他们。
A blow to the back of my head reminded me that I did not have a choice.
但是我在脑后的这个一个重击提醒我，这个我并没有选择。
Why should I bear the cross for the guilty?
为什么我要为一个无辜的人背起十字架呢？
I was innocent.
我是无辜的。
Now I feel the shame that I ever thought that.
我现在想起来我都感觉惭愧。
The crossbeam was set on my back and I walked last in the procession.
这个十字架的横木被放在我的背上，然后我就推开这个人群。
I was behind the soldiers, pushing the crowd out of the way and behind the condemned man.
紧跟在这个被判死、这个被判定罪的这个人的后面。
We pushed and stumbled our way through one of the gates of the city.
我们一路的推上，然后跌跌撞撞的来到这个城门。
We went up a hill to the place of the skull where executions took place.
我们来到一座小山，就在那里的话。就是那个行刑之处。
I threw the cross off my back.
我把十字架从我的背上扔下来。
It was no longer mine. It belonged to another.
这个不再是我的，是别人的了。
And then suddenly, I found myself face to face with the condemned man.
突然之间，我发现我跟这个被定罪的人的话，这个面对面的站着。
It was like time stood still long enough for me to see with open eyes.
时间在这个时候都仿佛停止，因为我们可以跟他，这个面对面看得很清楚。
The man was wearing a cruel crown made of twisted branches filled with sharp thorns that dug into his forehead.
那这个人的话，戴着这个扭曲的荆棘制成的这个冠冕， 然后上面长满了刺，也深深的刺入到他的额头。
I don't know how to explain what happened next.
我不知道接下去会发生什么。
When I faced the condemned man, I immediately recognized that he was my king.
当我面对这个被定罪的人的时候，立刻意识到他是我的王。
All my life, I had longed for the Messiah to come.
我的一生当中都在期盼弥赛亚的到来。
And here I was, standing in front of him face to face.
今天我现在就在这里跟他面对面。
He was beaten and bleeding, but somehow in control of the situation.
他被打得遍体鳞伤，但同时他却掌控全局。
He looked at me and said, "Thank you for what you did for me."
他看着我对我说，谢谢你为我所做的一切。
Those words just hung in the air for me to ponder.
这些的话都在我的脑边不断的环绕，让我去深思。
The sting of a Roman whip tearing my shirt and back informed me that I was no longer welcome there.
罗马人的鞭子在我的背上很清楚地提醒我，我在那里已经不再受欢迎。
The sky was growing dark.
天色也变得昏暗。
And I rushed off to search for my family.
我也开始离开，要去寻找我的家人。
I will never forget those words.
我永远都不会忘记那句话。
Thank you for what you did for me.
谢谢你为我所做的。
In my mind, I did not do this task for him.
在我看来，我并没有为他做什么。
I did not even choose it.
甚至我不是选择去做这样去做。
It was forced on me.
我只是被逼的勉强这样去做。
But somehow, my king recognized it was an act of service for him.
但是我的王却认可这个事情，把他这个看作是我对他的服侍。
The most important thing I ever did for Jesus was a task that I did not choose.
我为耶稣所做的最重要的事情是一件我被勉强去做的事。
I often had the opportunity to explain this thought to other believers.
我也有这个机会把这样的想法给其他的信徒传达。
The most important thing you ever do for Jesus might be a task that you would never choose.
就是你为耶稣所做的事情，可能是一件你自己不会主动去选择去做的事情。
I never met a believer who chose to have a child with special needs.
我从来没有遇见一个信徒会选择去拥有一个这个特别的这些需要的孩子。
A child who could not see or hear or speak or walk.
比如说一个看不见、听不见、没法说话或是行走的孩子。
I never met a believer who chose to have a rebellious son.
我从来没有遇见一个信徒选择要有一个悖逆的孩子。
A son who walked away from God in order to live in shameful ways.
一个选择背离上帝并且在这个羞耻当中生活的人。
I never met a believer who chose to live with financial difficulties.
我从来没遇见一个信徒选择生活在贫困之中。
The list could go on and on because life is difficult and often unfair.
这个清单可以不断的继续下去，因为生活是困难的，然后也常常是不公平。
What if Jesus came to you and said, "Would you carry this heavy burden for me?"
如果耶稣来找你，问你说，你愿意为我担这个沉重的重担吗
？What would you say？
你会说什么呢
？Jesus wants his followers to reflect his love for the broken and for the lost。
耶稣希望他的追随者活出，他对这些破碎跟失丧者的爱。
Jesus wants his followers to show the world that they do not serve him for financial gain.
耶稣希望他的追随者向这个世界证明他们并不是为金钱而服侍。
They serve him only because he's worthy of all of our love.
他们去侍奉他是因为他配得这个我们所有的爱。
I have found it necessary to explain all of this to other believers who face difficult tasks in life that they never chose.
我 我也觉得有必要向生活中面临身不由己的各样的困难的这些其他的信徒解释所有的这些的东西。
These unchosen tasks can be done for Jesus.
这些无可奈何的工作的话呢，也可以成为是你为耶稣所做的。
I always end these conversations by telling them to remember that someday you will stand before your King face to face.
在结束谈话的时候，我总是会想告诉他们，将来有一天你会面对面的站在你的王的面前。
He knows all about the difficult tasks that you never chose.
他知道你所有的你这个没有选择去做的事情。
The tasks that were forced on you.
就是那些强加在你身上的这些工作。
The ones that seem so unfair.
就是那些看起来是这么的不公正的事情。
And he will say to you, thank you for what you did for me.
他会对你说，谢谢你为我所做的。
Signed, your brother in Christ, Simon of Cyrene.
你在耶稣基督里的弟兄古利奈人西门。
Let's pray.
我们来祷告。
Dear Father in heaven, we ask that you would help us to serve you in everything in life.
亲爱的天父，我们恳求你帮助我们在生活当中所有的事情上能够去侍奉你。
Even the tasks that we do not choose.
即使是在那些我们没有选择的事情上面。
And help us to always to remember.
帮助我们能够始终去铭记。
That our King is worth it.
就是我们的王是配得这一切的。
In Jesus' name, amen.
帮助耶稣基督的名祷告，阿们。
Thank you very much, Dr. Joel Williams, for this timely, encouraging message. 谢谢为耶尔博士给我们这么美好的信息来鼓励我们。我先读一段经文let me first read from a passage that we are very familiar with. The Lord says to the Apostle Paul, My grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. So whatever you will go through in 2024, we trust that the Lord's grace is sufficient for us. 上帝对保罗所说的，我们也很熟悉的，我的恩典够你用，因为我的能力是在人的软弱上显得完全。所以2024年我们将要面临的挑战，我们没有人能够预料到，但是知道我们的上帝的恩典是够我们用的。求主帮助我们，鼓励我们，坚固我们。May the Lord continue to strengthen us as we face this new year. Thank you, Dr. Kang Pin, Xi Jinming, Liu Wenwu, and Ma Jing for your service this morning. 谢谢 Kang Pin 博士、Xi Jinming, Liu Wenwu 跟 Ma Jing 同学们他们的服侍。首先又恭喜大家新年好祝大家新年好I wish everyone a happy new year. Welcome to our first chapel of 2024. At this time, may I request Dr. Michael Melissa to close us in prayer and especially to pray for the family of Dr. Neil and to give us the benediction. 现在我们大家起立。我们请麦克博士为我们祷告祝福。
Dear Lord, you're the God of all comfort, and we pray for the family of our President Dr. Neil T. And all the relatives that you would be near them with your peace and your comfort in this time of grieving. And we pray that you would help them through this difficult time.And we also want to thank you for your word that speaks to us on a daily basis. Thank you for giving it to us. And thank you also for the sermon that we heard this morning. And it's so great to hear about you dying for us rendering the greatest service you could give. And we thank you that you also called us into your service and allowed us to serve you. And we pray that you would help us in our journey in serving you. Amen.
Please be seated. You are dismissed after a moment of silent prayer. 请坐，默祷后，我们就散会，可以去用餐。谢谢。